Good afternoon. So my name is Pierre-Yves Le Trahan. I'm the scientific director of Mercator Ocean International, the global ocean forecasting center located in Toulouse, France, and also in charge of the implementation of the Copernicus Marine Service. So my presentation deals with mobilizing European resources to strengthen the GeoBlueplanet initiative. And I want to thank here my two co-authors, so Jan Rambouwer from the European Commission, and Emil Ismail from NOAA, Executive Director of GeoBlueplanet. So first, a few words on the GeoBlueplanet initiative. So GeoBlueplanet is the ocean and coastal initiative of GEO. Its mission is to advance and exploit synergy among the observational programs devoted to ocean and coastal water, and to improve the engagement with users and enhancing the application and services that can be delivered from ocean observation. And finally, to raise awareness of the societal benefits of ocean observation. So GeoBlueplanet is organized in a series of working groups where really there is a brainstorming on different activities to be developed. And when it comes to practical implementation, this is done through dedicated projects. So you have here the list of projects that are today running as part of GeoBlueplanet, for instance, monitoring and forecasting of maritime hazard, global eutrophication monitoring, or sargassum monitoring. So in terms of resource history for GeoBlueplanet, so NOAA Satellite Oceanography and Climatology Division has been supporting the Secretariat since 2015. And the way to organize the international coordination around GeoBlueplanet has been done through workshops and symposiums that have been funded through proposal and support from participating organizations. For instance, the last GeoBlueplanet symposium was organized in Europe, in Toulouse, and was funded by Mercator Ocean on the Copernicus Marine Service. So in terms of activity at European level, so first, as you know, the European Union is a driving force within GEO. The European Commission is a founding member, one of the four co-chairs of GEO, and EU member states contribute actively to GEO. As far as the GeoBlueplanet initiative is concerned, so all activity deals with ocean observation, marine information, application and services. There are major European Commission contributions as part of the DGRTD research program, so H2020 Horizon Europe, but also the DG DFIS Copernicus program on its marine service and the DG Mare ImoNet initiative. As an example of European activities that are relevant to the GeoBlueplanet activities, so all what has been done as part of this H2020 research program, this is a list of funded projects for the last 5 years. Dealing with ocean observation. So 120 projects has been funded with a budget above 400 million euros and for a wide range of activity dealing from data, technology, new observation for ocean health, for climate, for coastal application and so on. This is already a major effort of European Commission. Okay. So with a growing portfolio of activities and interests in a GeoBlueplanet, there is a need for increased resources, however, for the international coordination. So Mercator Ocean International has been recently tasked by the European Commission to strengthen the European Union contribution, visibility and influence in GeoBlueplanet. And to address this need, Mercator is setting up within its organization a GeoBlueplanet European office. And the office will be in place next October, and it will monitor and promote European programs, projects and activities with relevance to GeoBlueplanet. So of course, Copernicus Services, Horizon Europe on H2020, European Research Infrastructure, ImoNet. We also monitor, promote GeoBlueplanet activities which are beneficial for Europe, scrutinize the GeoBlueplanet implementation plan on possible European activities and introduce new European relevant thematic activities, and of course, provide technical support to the international GeoBlueplanet activities. And I think this is a very good example of resource mobilization to improve the coordination and support the development of a major initiative of GEO. And key factor of success was the alignment of priorities between European and international efforts to better link ocean observation to societal needs. It was also related to a shared recognition of the critical importance and relevance of the Geoplanet Initiative. Thank you.